Hey, what's up? It's Greg from Fisherman's Headquarters, and today is Friday, August 20th. I'm up here on the Mid-Island Surf, checking out the scene here at about 4 o'clock in the afternoon. Just finished up an awesome afternoon surf sesh here right up the street from the shop. And I can share with you guys that we've got a lot of different things going on right now on Long Beach Island. If you want to check out the fishing report update, check out fishinglbi.com. Just threw a quick one up there with also a link to yesterday's video report. And also have a couple things to share with you today. First, I wanted to talk about the storm we have currently brewing up, kind of cruising up, moving to the north in the Atlantic here. It's pumping some easterly groundswell, southeasterly groundswell right now into the beaches. Right now, groundswell is in the 3 to 4 foot range, occasional 5-6 foot swell on the beaches. Looks like that's going to increase into the later part of the day, tomorrow, and even Sunday. The exact track is somewhat, the certainty is somewhat confirmed. It's going north, exactly whereabouts, who knows. Whether it's going to go the western track or eastern track, but it's definitely trending up, kind of pointing up there towards Block Island area. If you haven't been paying attention, definitely check out the National Hurricane Center for updates on that. Just be informed if you're going out in the boat. Yeah, there's light winds, but there is some large, long period groundswell in the water now, and it will be throughout the entire weekend. What does that mean to you going fishing? That means outgoing tide in the inlet could be hairy. That means that if you see, an outgoing tide, you see some outer bar white water, stay away. It also means that if you are aware of the outer bars outside of Barnegat Inlet or some other areas, say down at Holgate, they're all shoaled up. It might look flat, calm, and beautiful, and then you kind of get yourself in a sticky situation when that long period swell shows up. Long period swells are much more spaced out than, say, a tight together chop that we commonly see. So that's just kind of a word of advice. Long period swells definitely can be sneakers and get you off guard. Long period swells will also somewhat mask the energy until they hit those bars. So you might see only 3 foot, 4 foot on the buoy, but a 3 to 4 foot swell at say 12, 13, 14, 15 seconds could be twice the size. 3 foot at 13 seconds could be 5-6 foot, if not bigger. With that said, there's a whole lot going on Long Beach Island right now. I just wanted to share the hold on 1 second here. There goes the boys. So just wanted to share a couple things as far as fishing goes. There are some kingfish up on the beach. Just talked to an angler right here, literally right up the street from the shop. He had a couple kingfish. Did not hear of a fluke here. He said he didn't have any fluke today, but there was a couple fluke caught yesterday. So that's kind of cool to hear. Literally right up the street from Fisherman's Headquarters here, 9th, 10th Street, Mid Island. Don't really want to give a spot burn, but it's a full on spot burn. Why not? It's a popular beach. Get down here, get fishing on LBI. There's kingfish, fluke off the beach. During my surf session, there was a whole pile, I'll say an acre or two, of small bait. Looked like to me, bay anchovies and spearing. Couldn't really tell exactly, but there was birds all of them, smaller terns that were kind of giving them away. And some small blues kind of popping around on them. The angler was fishing the beach, did not get the blues. These kind of fish were sitting a little further out on the backside of the bar in the outer part of the swell there. They weren't really in the wash. But something I do want to share with you guys is when I was actually on a couple waves inside on the foamy area up on the sandbar, I actually saw some V-wakes. And to me, that's mullet. I really don't want to go out and claim there's mullet here already. I know there are some in the bay. But to me, it was really, really awkward to see those V-wakes. And I would say a school of possibly 30, 40 baits is what it looked like to me. But to me, I couldn't really miss it. It was a distinct, small looking pile of mullet, a school of them, that were V-waking through. Just a few moments after that, I'll say maybe a couple minutes, maybe 5 minutes at most, a couple pelicans went diving around kind of that same area. So over the years for me, normally it's September, October, you have that warmer water. You get those shorter days, you get those pelicans that are here, and you see those V-wakes, and that's mullet run. That's a whole lot of good fishing fun. So hopefully that's a hint at maybe what's coming here soon. I don't want to claim the mullet run's on by any stretch of the imagination. It may be just a rare sighting, but it's good to see nonetheless. Something that was really cool I mentioned in the last report was some greenies. We had some greenback herring that were just caught by our local gill netter that was getting us bunker. So it's kind of here. It's kind of cool to hear there's other species around. I saw a couple Spanish mackerel jumping today just a short while ago. So it's definitely kind of awesome to see all these different species that are here right now. If you're looking for a more detailed report, definitely stop in Fisherman's Headquarters, talk to all the guys, talk to the crew. Love to help you guys out. Love you point in the right direction. If you're looking for some help, if you got some problems, you're not catching fish, if you want to try to catch more fish or bigger fish this year, love to help you out. Stop at Fisherman's Headquarters right after the first traffic light on the right-hand side upon entering Long Beach Island. You can also check us out on fishermansheadquarters.com or social media, Facebook, Instagram, or these YouTube videos. Appreciate everybody following along. Have a great day.